Welcome to a very special edition of Clatch Show today. Today we are going to have a topper's talk, okay? And we are going to introduce three of our very own homegrown talent, okay? That is Vinesh, Ashik, and Amrendra, okay? All three of them have performed really well and they have gotten into NALSAR, which is no mean feat. One of the best law schools in the country, a tier one law school. And, you know, pretty much they can be assured of a wonderful placement in a top tier law firm in India, okay? So, the fact is that knowledge is spread by sharing, right? And we all can learn something from those who have achieved and those who have succeeded, okay? So, I wanted to give all of you a chance to interact with these people and to get an idea of how they did it, and not only how, but why they did it, okay? Because everybody has a different why. My reason for doing something might be very different from yours. Motivation is the key factor, okay? Along with discipline. So, without further ado, let me introduce the three stars in the bright galaxy of CLAT, okay? So, I would request Vinesh, Ashik, and Amrendra to please switch on their videos, and I will unmute them at the same time. Okay, Ashik, Amrendra, and Vinesh. Okay, here we are. Okay, so first of all, welcome to all three of you. Okay, and thank you for sharing your time to benefit the students who are going to be writing the exam in 2021 and some in 2022 as well. Okay, so first and foremost, I think hearty congratulations from me personally.
Thank you, sir.
Each and every one of the students in CLAT Show, we are all very, very proud of you. Just like your family members and your friends, I think we are also extended family at CLAT Show. Okay, and you have really shown the way for the future students on how and what it takes to succeed. Okay, so one by one, I would like you all to share your journey a little bit, maybe for 5 minutes. Just give me briefly, what led you to this point. And after that, I would like to ask you some specific questions. Okay, so for instance, what I would like to know from you is when did this idea of writing CLAT first come in your mind? Okay, secondly, when it came in your mind, then what did you do about it? Right, how did you go about it? And what were the hurdles in your way and those kind of things? Basically lead me from the journey of the day the thought first entered your mind to write CLAT, to right now when you are talking to all the students and, giving them your experiences, okay? So, Vinesh, why don't you go first? Tell us a little bit about yourself. Yeah.
Sir, actually, last year I attempted NEET and I cleared it, but I didn't want to pursue MBBS. So, I thought, why not try some other courses in which there are less number of people and a huge scope. And moreover, I wanted to go for judiciary from long time. I had always that dream. So I thought of writing CLAT, and from last year onwards, I started my preparation. And the preparation was good. The pattern changed in November. And suddenly it was a very, very big disaster for me. And so from there on, there were many, many surprises in our way. Like the sample papers released were just out of box. And the paper also was not as expected. So yeah, the preparation was good. And most of the focus was on GK and math section. And yeah, the preparation was good.
Okay, that's good to know. So basically, life threw you a few curveballs along the way, right? Which you never expected. But you just had to adapt and overcome. As they say, Charles Darwin, in fact, said that it's not the strongest who survives, but the one who is most able to adapt to change, right? So good. So you were able to do that. And glad to hear those opening thoughts from you. Amrendra, why don't you tell us as well? I would request everybody else to switch off their videos. Three people would have their videos on. Yes, go ahead, Amrendra, tell me.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Amrendra Shukla. I've secured an All India rank of 189 in CLAT 2020. So, sir, last year it was 8th of April 2019. And I gave my JEE mains and I came back home. And I told my father that, Papa, it is not happening. I don't think I'm getting a good rank in it. So my father has a law degree from DU. So he told me, why not write CLAT? So last year application dates were extended by 15 days. So I filled the form, and I filled form of one more college, that was Jamia Millia in Delhi.
Yeah.
And so because only these two application forms were open, I prepared for 1 month for CLAT, and I got an All India rank of 2561. And I also secured an All India rank of 1 in Jamia. So I enrolled in it because I did not want to drop a full year. And because CLAT is an unpredictable exam. And while studying in Jamia, I attempted CLAT again, and I got this result.
That's really great. One thing that I noticed in between both of your stories is that Vinesh is from a science background. Both of you are from science backgrounds, but in the sense that Vinesh chose a career in medicine before he gravitated towards law. And similarly, Amrendra, you had chosen a career in engineering before you gravitated towards law once again. So from both of you, I'd like to know, like, why this switch? Is it that law is a second best kind of, playing second fiddle to the engineering and medical professions?
No, sir. Actually, I didn't want to pursue MBBS. And moreover, my grandfather is also a lawyer in Supreme Court. So okay. He used to advise me. He used to tell me, like, every day, why not do CLAT? You should attempt once. So I thought I should follow his advice. And moreover, it has a scope, and I can prepare for judiciary as well, which was a dream from my childhood.
Certainly, certainly. Okay, that's good. And what about you, Amrendra?
Sir, I like debating on government policies and all that, but my father told me that why not, law is your backup option, and everybody in the family has a law degree. Why not, do something different? But God had other plans.
Okay, great. So you ended up following the family footsteps, right? As they say in the movie Batman, right? When Joker says that if you are good at something, don't do it for free. So, like, turns out that, you all had a family background in... just a second. Turns out that you had a family background in law, and ultimately that's where you ended up going anyway, right? So for me also personally, I used to love to, argue all the time, with everyone. I would love to, debate and everything. So like, if you're going to do that, why do it for free? Why not make a career out of it, right? So yes, that's what. Now we got an idea of, like, how and why you entered into this, side of it. Another thing I wanted to know is, like, which city are you all from? So, Vinesh, where are you from?
Sir, Kashipur, Uttarakhand.
Kashipur, Uttarakhand. And Amrendra, you?
Sir, I'm from Gurugram, Haryana.
Gurugram, Haryana. Okay. So, basically, what I have noticed in, the new pattern of CLAT especially is that it is more of an English comprehension paper. Okay. And it all depends on, like, whose, English language skills are the best. They are the ones who succeed. Okay. And many times we see, like, if we are not from such a good English speaking background, then sometimes we don't have an advantage over the others. Even if you see both the places you all are from, they are not, they are more like Hindi heartlands, right? They are not like English speaking dominated areas. So how did you overcome this, obstacle that you must have faced when it comes to the language barrier?
So, like, my father always told me to read newspapers, and from eighth class onwards, I used to read the Hindu daily. So it was into my daily schedule that I used to read newspapers, and moreover, I was into novels.
Right.
So I was habitual of reading, and moreover, I like to do it.
Okay, great. So you feel that the reading habit that was inculcated in you from a young age, that's held you in good stead, right? Okay.
Yes, sir.
And what about you, Amrendra?
Sir, my school has a very good library. So I have the same story as Vinesh. My father told me to develop a reading habit, and I did the same. And
so, like, I told you that I used to read newspapers from an early age, and like, in the last 1 year, I used to read two newspapers a day, like the Hindu and Indian Express. So I had a grip on editorials and mostly the current affairs and the political opinions. Like, there are some channels on YouTube, like Study IQ, in which the international relations are explained very well. Moreover, there are different websites for the current affairs and general knowledge, like Drishti IAS. For the new pattern, Drishti IAS is the best. Like, they have elaborated current affairs and they go on to, into the history of the topic and bring in the most minute details of the topic.
Right, right. Okay, yes, definitely. And what about you, Amrendra?
So I think reading newspaper is the most important thing. You know, while reading editorials, one should think that one should analyze why the author has said this and why is it happening. I mean, start asking questions. Like in that Donald Trump question, one should have, you know, asked himself that why is Donald Trump interfering between Israel and UAE? He's the president of the United States. So, asking questions is the thing. And reading newspapers religiously is what will get one ahead.
Right. Okay. Agreed. And what about you, Ashik? Do you have anything to add to this?
Yes, sir. So for GK, I have a specific, very specific strategy. Okay. Your question was whether you should just read the newspaper or just, you know, what extra should you do? And I think when you're reading newspapers, it's important to analyze it and take notes at the same time. I mentioned this in the group before, but I maintained a Google Sheets document where I kept all the events month-wise. And each time anything related to that event happens, I'll add details to that.
Okay.
Critical thinking comes to the fore, because when you're reading newspapers, you're just reading opinions. You need to consider multiple sources to determine the absolute truth of things. So that's my take on it.
So now I think one common thread that has come through from all of these people is that y'all must all not only read editorials of the papers, but also read the newspaper itself, not just the editorial, but the other things. And not only one newspaper, but multiple sources. It could be like, you know, one newspaper, one magazine, etc., etc. But you must also prepare some kind of a list for yourself. Okay, like some kind of a Google document, or maybe it could be a physical document also. Note down all the points that you are learning, so that by the end of the year, you have your own kind of compendium, daily compendiums, weekly compendiums, monthly compendiums. That's your own one. Okay. Now, one very important thing I find is, like, you know, while we are discussing all these strategies which play to the strengths of the people, of like how I did this and how I did that, don't think that a topper is like invincible. Don't think that a topper was born a topper. Okay. A topper is somebody who had a very good day. Okay. It is a lot of effort. It is a lot of hard work. Blood, sweat and tears mixed with that X factor of luck. Okay, that's what really makes a topper. Okay, there might have been a lot of other people who were good, but just not good enough on that particular day. Okay, so I want to look at the dark side of preparation. Okay, for a minute. Now that we have celebrated the success, every person has a weak point. Okay, every person has a weak subject. For me, it was maths. I just could not figure out maths at all. Okay. On the other hand, for me, English was a breeze. I didn't even need to read the book. I could just answer all the questions because I had a base in English. Okay. In like debating and all from school days. Okay. So I would like to ask each of you, what was your weak point? What was your weak subject and how did you overcome that? Because obviously you overcame it. That's why you are in Natsar today. So we need to know how. Okay. Tell us your secrets. Go ahead. First, we'll ask Vinesh, then Amrendra and then Ashik. Okay.
No weak subjects.
No weak subjects. Okay, I like that confidence. It's like asking someone in cricket, what do you play? Batsman, bowler, they say all-rounders. Okay, so that means I am all the side, I'm confident. No problem. Okay, good, Vinesh. Sometimes it's good to be honest, you know. Sometimes it's not arrogance, sometimes it's honesty, right? So if he always knew from the starting that he's going to make it, and he did. Great, very good. Okay, yes, Amrendra.
So maths was my weak subject and I could not overcome it. On the exam day also, I did not attempt even a single question of maths. And I think it was one of the biggest mistakes of my preparation.
Okay.
Because I should have focused on maths.
Okay.
And I might have got an extra 3 to 4 marks in it.
Okay. So even now you feel that you did not give enough attention to maths. You should have given more attention. Even though yes, you have already made it, you feel like maybe that would have been the difference between NALSAR and NLS. Right?
Yes, sir.
It's very, very true. People miss out NLS from half a mark also. If you had prepared a little more on maths and you had gotten 3-4 marks more, maybe you would have made it all the way to NLS as well, right? Okay. Yes, Ashik, what about you?
Sir, as Amrit said, yes, sir, but the biggest regret that I had was with the maths preparation. And as you pointed out, the difference between like most NALSARITES and the analysts IU kids is like a matter of 2.75 marks, like the rank and the mark difference. And right. One of the good things that I did during the exam was I did only one question of maths, that's a short question of math, and I got around 4 marks with it. And I know someone who had equal preparation with me. I know someone who did the same amount of prep as me. But the mistake he did was he attempted the math question fully. The important thing with regards to your weak point in CLAT is that if you don't know something, skip it if it's beyond 60 seconds, because it's a huge waste of time. And this is something that my sister, who is also like into entrance exams, told me. And this is important. This is important because it's a matter of opportunity cost. What other questions you can attempt in those 60 seconds that you could have, you know, better utilized. And one more big fear of mine is the fact that the consortium has been like messing around with the math part of it, because they said it's going to be easy, basic 10th standard math. And then the first example problem that they gave was something with the furniture and carpenters. Then on the day of the exam, they gave some, I have no idea what it was. It was so concerning, because I got the answer. I know it was the right answer, but the option is not there. It was so, I don't know how to put it in words, but that was like the weak part of
low point.
And I think I should have put more effort in.
Right. Okay. Fair enough. Fair enough. So good. That gives us an idea into the, you know, dark side of preparation also. And, you know, the day that the paper comes, don't think that the toppers had a wonderful day either. Okay, even the toppers faced a lot of problems, right? Like Ashik in the middle of the exam hall found himself giving the correct answer with the wrong option. Right, there's a right answer, but there's no right option. What are you going to do when you know more than CLAT? This can also happen, right? Sometimes you know, you face such a situation where I remember in my paper, the question they had given was Sania Mirza plays which sport. I spent 5 minutes just trying to understand what is this question. Is it a trick question? Is it some other science? Is it Saina Nehwal they're asking? I was just so confused. But that's the thing, okay? If they are going to ask a question like which sport does Sania Mirza play, everyone is going to answer that question. You see, it's not just me who knows the answer. That means the paper goes down from being 150 marks paper to 149 marks. That means the cutoffs are going to be even closer. So if there are 5 questions, out of which question, 4 of them are like, which sport does Sachin Tendulkar play? Which sport does this one play, that one play? Everyone will get those 4. And then they will ask, who is the squash champion of the world? Which no one knows, right? So the whole game will be on that one mark. It's just like what we are discussing right now. You know, it's all about those inches. The inches are the things that make the difference between winning and losing, living and dying. Okay, that's what you have to remember. All right. Now, taking the topic from the weakest to the strongest. Okay, while for some of you, maths might have been tough, some other subject might have been tough. Which was the subject that you breezed through? Like I mentioned earlier, for me, English, I didn't even need to open the book. I was like, this is a joke. Like antonym, synonym and everything. I had studied, I had the habit of reading since I was not even able to walk. Okay, so it was for me no problem. But, you know, that doesn't mean you should take something for granted. I still did some effort. Okay, so similarly, I would like to know for you all, what was your strong point and what was your strategy for approaching it? Okay.
May I start?
Yes, please.
So like logical reasoning and maths were my strong points. I gave time to maths every day, like an hour or two from the time it was first postponed. Before that, I didn't used to prepare. I didn't prepare for maths. Like I thought I would do 5-6 questions of maths and they would suffice. But then I got extra time and then I tried to prepare and I cleared my concepts from several books like R.S. Agarwal. And then I attempted mocks. Moreover, logical reasoning was my very strong point. I didn't have any need to practice so much for logical reasoning. I just attempted that in mocks. And like editorial reading helped me in that. Like I used to analyze the editorials given and that helped me a lot.
Okay, so basically for you maths was a strong point, and for logical you used to apart from everything else solve the editorial, read the editorials once again, which helped you for English, logical, etc. What about the other subjects? I think you said that maths was your strong point. Vinesh, I wanted to ask you, apart from, you have told us about logical, you have told us about maths, right? Why don't you tell us about the remaining, and we will ask Amrendra and Ashik also the same thing, your strongest subject, and then how your preparation strategies for the other subjects as well. Okay,
so like reading newspapers and several legal books helped me in all the three subjects, so English, logical and legal. GK was something separate. I used to give around 5 to 6 hours daily for GK. I referred to 2-3 sources, plus I read newspapers daily, I made my own notes and referred to some other monthly compilations. So it went around 5-6 hours daily for GK. And rest, it was all from like reading and practicing.
You mean like from the beginning to the end, it was 5-6 hours. Like, yes, sir, like 5 hours, like daily, every month for GK.
Yes, sir. Almost. From October or November last year.
Okay. And how much time did you prepare daily?
Around 10 to 12. Like I didn't have anything else to do. So I invested the whole of my time to.
For how long? When did you start your preparation?
In July last year,
July 2019. So yes, you have taken a drop basically.
Yes, sir.
So from 1.5 years basically, you have been preparing for 10 to 12 hours a day. Ladies and gentlemen,
I used to take a break on Saturday and Sunday.
Right. Ladies and gentlemen, this is what it takes to get into NALSAR. 10 to 12 hours daily for 1.5 years, out of which 4 to 5 hours for GK. Okay.
Sir, I want to add on the previous question, which is your strongest subject. And as I already mentioned, I am already a first year law student. Like I finished my first year in my college year. And one of the things that helped me during legal was the pre-existing knowledge that like the law students in the first year have. Let's say, for example, one specific question was regarding Article 22, rights of the detained people. A person who went to law school or did legal studies in their 12th would know the positive effect. Like the detainees can take advantage of the positive changes in law when it's changed. Only the retrospective of negative punishment is denied, is not given to the detainees. This kind of specific knowledge is like, it's available to people who have done law. I'm not saying go to law first year and come back and do it. I'm just saying read more when it comes to all these things. And yeah, my strongest subject is legal, because I'm sure even Vinesh and Amrendra would agree with me, because we knew almost all the passages. We literally didn't need to read the passage. We can directly move on to the questions. And when I came out of the exam and I asked my friends, bro, how was legal? They were like, bro, it was hard. I was like, it was a cakewalk. I could answer everything easily. And that was my highest scoring section. The legal is what made me, you know, get ahead in the ranks.
Great. Thanks for that, Ashik. And before we move to Amrendra, I would like to welcome Rishabh, sir, who, as you know, is a faculty member at Faculty. Okay, so hi Rishabh, welcome to the session.
Hi guys, please continue. I like, compared to all of you new toppers, I gave CLAT in 2017, so that makes me a CLAT dinosaur. And Vishrut sir is even older.
I would be a fossil then. If you are a dinosaur, then I'm a fossil.
So I'm looking forward to learning all your strategies and understanding what were the reasons behind your success. And I hope that the students who have joined us today will take inspiration from you and follow in your path and achieve success and, you know, make us proud. Thank you. Please continue.
Right. So Amrendra, a similar question for you as well. Why don't you tell us, like, first of all, your strongest subject, and then also regarding the remaining subjects, what was your preparation strategy?
Sir, I think my strongest subject was legal. I was also already enrolled in a college, so I guess that helped me a lot, because I completed Law of Torts and Law of Contract from R.K. Bangia. I read both the books completely, and I guess that helped me a lot. And regarding number of hours, I studied daily. I don't think more than 5 to 6 hours, because when you're in a college, you tend to have, you know, more fun, and you tend to attend more fests and all that. You are, you know, excited to spend time with your friends and all. So I did all of that, but I don't think I studied more than 5 to 6 hours any day.
Okay.
On any day.
Okay. So I guess all three of you have been retaking the exam in 2020, right?
First time.
Sorry?
Sir, it was my first attempt.
Okay, but you you dropped a year, right?
Yes, sir.
So all three of you, I think either you dropped a year or you kind of did it alongside with college. That means you retook it, right? So that means that you had enough time, even if you did only 5 hours a day. How many months had you been preparing, Amrendra, for CLAT?
So I started preparing from July. But I gave my first mock in October. Then I gave my second mock in December. I gave my third, fourth, and fifth mock in January. And from February, I gave at least, you know, 8 mocks each month till June. From July, I started giving, you know, a mock every alternate day. So okay. I guess giving mocks and analyzing them. And I analyzed each mock at least 4 to 5 times. So that helped me a lot.
Right. So basically, all of you at least have been preparing for 1.5 years. Okay. And a minimum of 5 to 6 hours a day. And if only 5 to 6 hours a day, then also you have been going to college. Not like if you have been taking a complete drop, you have been studying 5 to 6 hours a day. 5 to 6 hours a day is with partial drop. So you have university in the first half and then your own self-study in second half. And don't forget that when you are in your first year in college, you are anyway learning taught, contract, other principles of law, along with that other subjects, right? So like you said, you have studied 2 volumes of Bhangia. Okay. Along with that, you have been preparing for CLAT. Now, Bhangia, of course, compared to CLAT level is very, very high. So if you are able to study Bhangia, for you, legal reasoning will obviously be a strong point, like it was for you, right? So this is the point. These people had 1.5 hours. If they were studying in college, then they were studying for 6 hours for CLAT. If they were not studying in college, they were studying for 12 hours for CLAT. Okay. Plus they had 1.5 years. Right now, we have hardly 6 months. Right. We have hardly 6 months to the next exam. So that means we should be studying at least 15 hours a day, isn't it? By that logic. Okay. So if you cannot manage 15, remember that every minute less than 15 is something you are doing less than what you should be doing. If you study 10, that's fine. If you study 5, that's fine. But remember that if you're studying 10, you're studying 5 less than you should be studying. If you're studying 5, it's 10 less than you should be studying. Okay. You don't have much time. You don't have the luxury of like sitting and, you know, sitting around and like taking mocks once a month or whatever, like he did in the initial part. You have to straight away jump to the end of his preparation part where he was taking mocks nearly every day. Right. We need to fast forward to that place. All right. So this is one lesson we take away. While talking about this, we also mentioned when you're preparing for 1.5 years, definitely the last half of that year was the pandemic. Okay. Your exam was supposed to have been somewhere in May, became June, July, August, September, like that. It kept getting postponed further and further. What did you do to keep your motivation up? Were you able to still study at the same pace, or were you like, oh, now I got to give up. I don't know. Let me just, whenever they take the exam, I'll go and give it. So what was your mental makeup at that point of time? Amrendra, let's start with you.
So I believe that, you know, I was really not much, I was not very much happy with Jamia. So I thought, you know, I've got a good amount of time now and I'll give my everything. So to make it to NLS or NALSAR. You know, I was a little bit depressed from, you know, because of Jamia. So yeah, that was my motivation.
That's quite a jump, huh? From Jamia to NALSAR, right? Yeah. I wrote a book. Yeah. The pandemic hit. I thought, okay, fine. I have time. Let's write a book. Isn't it? So you have to keep your... If I had thought, oh my God, my center has shut down. Now how will I earn money? Now everything is lost. It's useless. What's the point of thinking like that, right? So things work out. If you keep a positive attitude, things work out. What about you, Vinesh?
Sir, I was already motivated. Like I dropped an year and it was the last chance. So I had to give everything I had. And moreover, like whenever I wanted, I used to read like some biographies of some entrepreneurs like Elon Musk and all. So that also motivated me, and many more, like the biography of Jeff Bezos and some self-help books also. So they helped me a lot during the period of pandemic.
Even I used to read a lot of self-help books during this period of my life, because at that time you really need some hardcore motivation. Okay, I'll tell you some of the books I read was, one book was called How to Talk to Anyone by Leigh Launders, 92 Tips and Tricks. So one of those body language techniques. Okay, then there was some more like Think and Grow Rich. Okay, there was a book called How to Win Friends and Influence People by Dale Carnegie. Yes, yes. Rishabh. Just a second, I'll unmute you. Yeah.
I would like to add one book which I just can't recommend enough to all the participants of this session. There's this book called Make It Stick. It's about efficient study techniques. So it has a lot of research. It's taken from a lot of studies that have been done on studying and study techniques, and it shatters a lot of assumptions that we have about how we go about our studying. So I want you, everyone should, whether you're in school, whether you're in college, postgraduate, everyone should read that book, because it just changed my life, and okay. I can't recommend it enough.
Great. Thanks, Rishabh. That's one habit of a topper right there. What Amrendra did is that when Rishabh suggested him a book, he immediately noted down the name. Right. And these guys are here to give, advice to you. I hope you all are at least here to take the advice properly. Right. Similarly, another book is called, even I have kept a notebook with me, and I'm noting down the kind of points that we're discussing and, further talking points. You should always have something in handy. Right. Similarly, one more book is called 7 Habits of Highly Effective People. Okay. By Stephen Covey, that is actually taught in corporate firms as part of the HR training. Even when I was there, they had offered it to us. So these kind of things really help you stay motivated, in your times, right? And Ashik, let's hear from you as well. I think Ashik has dropped off somehow. Okay, he will be back. All right. So these are some of the things which, preliminary we wanted to discuss. Okay. Now, you mentioned that somebody spends 6 hours, somebody spends 10 hours, but what does it actually comprise of? When you say I analyze a mock, what does it actually comprise of? Because students say I study 10 hours and I ask, what did you study for 10 hours? Oh, I was reading newspaper for 5-6 hours. What were you reading newspaper? Oh, I was just like flipping through that, some editorials. I said, what? No idea. So just wasting time, fooling themselves. I don't care how much you studied, right? I only care what's your rank. So basically, am I going to have a Zoom meeting with you or not next year? That's my only concern. Now, after you finish, then I'm going to sit and ask you that, what did you do? How did you do? Right now, don't bother to come and tell me. So do it honestly, right? Similarly, now that these guys have actually made it, I want to ask them to dissect their day and tell me how they went about it. When you studied 6 hours, how did you study? When you studied 10 hours, how did you study? Okay. So Vinesh, tell us, how did you spend those 10 hours?
Yeah, I prepared a weekly timetable from Monday to Saturday, and every day I had some target to complete. Like newspaper was fixed, around 3 to 4 hours of newspaper was fixed, and some other GK for around 2 to 3 hours, 1 to 2 hours for maths and other readings or mocks. I used to attempt mocks only on Sundays, and that was my only strategy. I had my weekly target fixed. And I used to stuck them on pinboard, so I can make a checkbox, a checklist of what I am doing and how I am doing that, and whether it is completed in time or not. So that daily seeing that checklist in front of my eyes, so I completed that, and the targets, if the targets are completed, then you can sleep well. Otherwise,
absolutely.
In the night, yeah,
absolutely. I used to have a sheet of paper with that particular day's work written on it. And every time I finished something, I would highlight it. Okay. So my goal was to have that whole sheet of paper highlighted before I went to sleep. And that would give me the greatest satisfaction. Trust me, like just finishing that, highlighting that entire sheet, right? It was a great pleasure. And similarly, I would like post motivational things for myself. Okay. So like, for example, I posted the picture of NUJS on my desk. okay, on my wall. I would look at it every day. When you're passing by, it look, okay, I have to go here. Right? Like that. I would put very simple, simple messages to myself. You can do it. Come on. You know, this, that, whatever it is, and post it on the wall in front of you. So every day, I had one thermocol stuck on the wall in front of me. And there I would, with pins, I would like post all these kind of things. So it's like a daily motivation for yourself in front of you. Okay? What about you, Amrinder?
So I think motivation does not work that much. At least for me. Yes, sir. So I think that one should develop habits. Right. And like from July to till March, I had to attend a college. So I used to wake up at 6 and go to my college. And I used to come back by 8 p.m. And from 9 to 1, I studied for those months from July till March. And starting from April, I studied at least, 6 to 8 hours. For that time, but my average comes out to be 6.
Okay, great. Okay, great. See, so you see different people, like, they say different strokes for different folks, right? So for somebody, motivation may not work, right? For that person, discipline is important. What do you think in army, the colonel or the major goes every morning and says, come on, you all can do it. He says, you get up and do 5 rounds of the field, right? It's just discipline. In army, you don't have to cajole somebody your mother asked you to eat your dinner, right? Over there, it's plain and simple discipline. Then even moving beyond discipline, because this discipline is kind of forcing yourself, isn't it? It's something like, okay, I have to do this, right? You have to move to a value-based framework. Value-based framework means the value of learning. I'm not doing this because I'm motivated, because I wrote on the wall that I have to do it and, I have to highlight everything. That is one way of doing it. The second way of doing it, like, no, I am going to do it because I promised myself I will do it. And, there's no way I will not do it. That's discipline. The third is value-based. You're like, I must learn because there is value in learning. If I learn, then I will go to a college where I will learn even more. And that is not like it will do good for my career. I will earn a lot of money. But rather, I will contribute to society. I will have a valuable life. There will be meaning to my existence. Things like that. That, in fact, is known as the best way of preparation. So I think something along those lines has guided Amrinder. Great. Something along the lines of motivation has guided Vinesh. Something along the lines of discipline might guide you. But whatever it is, okay, make sure that your goal is the same and you achieve that somehow or the other. Okay. Great. Now, moving on to one of the very major considerations, especially in this paper, is because you have seen that the number of questions has gone down from 200 to 150. But the difficulty level has gone up way more than that. So rather than make it easier in a perspective of time, that I don't have to answer 200, I have to answer 150 questions, it's become more difficult from a time management perspective. So how did you manage your time? Please tell us. Okay, Amrinder, go ahead.
So while giving mocks, I used to, I do not give a mock for 2 hours, but I finish my mock at 1 hour and 50 minutes, so that I can learn to manage time much more efficiently, and it helped me in the main exam, because usually I took only 8 to 10 minutes to do GK, but in the main exam it took me 20 minutes to do that GK, because I was really shocked and I had a panic attack just 5 minutes into the exam because of the lengthy GK that they had given us. And so I guess, and after that 20 minutes in the main exam, and because I had, saved that 10 minutes in the last, because I used to give mocks, I used to attempt the mock in only 1 hour and 50 minutes. That helped me a lot. So I think that people can try that.
Absolutely. And what about you, Vinesh?
So I had fixed timings for every subject. I didn't have any fixed pattern to attempt, like first GK or any other subject. I just used to allot a fixed time. My pattern varied a lot. In starting, I attempted legal first, then I went on GK, and it varied a lot. But the timing used to be fixed. Like English was to be done in 25 minutes, legal was to be done in 35 to 40 minutes, GK at max 10 minutes, and I used to give more time to maths. It could be a scoring subject at times.
Right.
So I used to give 20 minutes, around 20 minutes to maths and around 25 minutes to logical. So
okay.
It was completed in around 115 minutes. The main paper also.
So you actually had 5 minutes left over during the official CLAT 2020. Yes, even sir. After that whole maths question, which was wrong, even though you must have been very confused by that.
Still,
you had some time left. Okay.
Yes,
what about skipping questions? It's a very related question. How many questions did you actually skip?
So like, I only skipped questions in GK. Otherwise, I attempted most of the questions. Like one or two questions were skipped in maths. And rest, I attempted all of the questions. You can attempt like legal, logical, and English can be attempted, but only if your GK is it like you know you attempt or you don't know you don't. If you don't know, you leave it. In maths, like
of course, if you have a time doubt, right? And of course, if you have a doubt between two options, you can guess like 5-6 of them. You don't have to guess all of them, but you can guess 4-5 because even if you get one right, it's fine. You know, like it kind of washes away the sins of the remaining three, right? So that's okay. And do you remember how many questions you attempted and how many you got right by any chance? Do you remember?
I don't remember exactly. It was around 139 or 140 questions I attempted, and around 100 questions or 105 questions were correct.
Okay, fair enough. Fair enough. And what was your total score, final score?
So 92.5.
92.5. There you have it. That's a topper score, right? And what about you, Amrendra?
Sir, I attempted around 132 questions, but I had marked at least 15 to 17 questions for marked for review, and I lost all of them, and I scored 89.
Oh, very good. Very good. Okay, great. What about the same thing, time management and skipping questions? Skipping questions, how did you actually decide, okay, I'm going to skip this question? Was it only GK like Vinesh, know or don't know, or was it other subjects as well?
Sir, no, I did not skip any question in any other subject except GK, because I think that I had a strategy that I'll mark these many questions for marked for review, and they will be evaluated because that was the norm in coaching mocks. So I marked them. I was unsure about them, but I marked them. And I was pretty much sure that they will be evaluated.
Correct.
That did not happen.
Unfortunate. And this is a case for many, many students as well. It's just unfortunate because they should have made it a bit clearer. While, okay, fine, legally they are right because they did make a disclaimer at the beginning of this thing. But it's a pandemic, for God's sake. You know, like they need to give some more liberty to the people. But it's okay. That's how the cookie crumbles. You just have to, like, flow with it. You know, sometimes it works for you, sometimes it doesn't. Like, brush it off and move on. It's okay. So from my side, there will be one last question, and then Rishabh will ask a few, and then we will leave the floor open, okay, for the students to ask their questions. My last question to all of you was, how did it feel when you found out that you have got into NALSAR, right? And what was your family's reaction as well?
So, may I start?
Yeah.
So, like, my father only checked the results. I wasn't able to see the results also. I was out of the room. So, I was just waiting for their reaction. And they just came and told me that my rank was around 108. So, my first reaction was, like, I was only 15 ranks away from NLS. But then I thought...
Never satisfied.
Then I thought it's great to get a college, first year college, and NALSAR is also a good college. So yeah, I was happy. My family was super happy. They were like, just like...
Lovely. Very nice. And you, Amrendra?
So my dream college was in Ilu, Jodhpur. So when I got All India Rank 189, I was...
Your dream changed.
Yes, sir. My dream changed. And I was literally shocked because I expected a rank around 300 or 400. Mm. And even 600 would have been fine. But 189 was a surprise. And I think it was good. It was a good thing.
What about you, Rishabh? Do you remember?
My rank was 215. And my score was 127.5 or something like that. And my parents were very disappointed. They're extremely disappointed because they didn't want me to go for law anyway. They were like, my parents are from, like, my dad is a boomer, then my mother is from the 70s. They think that jiska kuch nahi hota hai, wo law karta hai.
Right. fair enough. Great. So this is the, apart from Rishabh's experience, this is the feeling I'm talking about. This is what it's all about. That one moment in time when you're like, oh, I made it to law school. And your entire life changes. You know, it's like probably like being selected to be a roadie or something like that, you know. It changes your entire life. Like, honestly, if I had to divide my life into two clear parts, one would be before I went to NUJS, and then second would be after I got into NUJS. I remember that moment in time when I got a call from my sister and she told me that I've gotten into NUJS. And my life changed forever. Okay. And things just keep getting better and better and better for you. Because I went to NUJS, I had such a great experience. Because I went to NUJS, I got such a good job. Because I got that job, I got a better and better and better job. So your life keeps improving. And if you go to a lower rung NLU, your life keeps getting worse. You can't get a good internship. You can't get a good job. You'll never get a good raise. You'll never get a good increase in your salary or a promotion, etc. So it's a downward spiral. And if you get a good NLU, it's an upward spiral. Okay. So I hope and pray for all of you all that it will be an upward spiral and you all will have that same feeling that the four people you see in front of you have had. Okay. I would like to see all of you join our club. Okay. So I hand it over to you, Rishabh. If you have any questions, please go ahead.
Guys, I joined a little late, so I don't know if you have discussed your strategies for the different sections. So if you haven't, then I would really be interested to know that, like, how you approached every single section.
We have touched very briefly, but let's hear in some detail, actually, section by section, you know, that would be actually very helpful for the students.
So may I go?
Yeah.
So, like, the best practice was from mocks only. I attempted around 55 to 60 mocks in the time of preparation. So the main focus was on managing the time. So if you are able to manage the time for each section, then you are in. If you are not only able to manage the timings, then there is a problem, and that has to be solved. Like, the section wise, like GK, I had already told you that there were many different sources, including Study IQ and all. And like, most of them were reading oriented, so the newspapers and novels and other legal books suffice for that. And maths, like, for clearing of concepts, I referred to R.S. Agarwal, and then the 55 to 60 mocks that I had attempted, I practiced around four to five times the maths questions in each mock from each mock.
Tell me something. How did you analyze a mock? Suppose you did a mock, you got, let's say, 100 on 150 in that mock. Okay. What is the meaning of analyze a mock for you?
So, like, I first just evaluated the marks, and then, like, I gave around 4 to 5 hours for analysis of a mock. Like, I started with English and went on, like, the questions I got right. So I would just match my reasoning, that what I thought was the explanation of the question, or they have done it by some other method, so that can be checked. And moreover, the questions I got wrong, that I used to bookmark them. We had an option on a portal to bookmark the wrong questions. So I used to bookmark those questions and always check them, like, once in a week or whenever I got time or whenever I wanted to do so. And like maths, I already told, I attempted around 4 to 5 times maths of every mock.
Right. Okay. So as you all know, like, you know, on the ClatSure app, you have the option for bookmarking the questions, so you can come back and review them later. You also get a very detailed analysis or a report card section wise. Okay, you got this much in that section, that much in that section. And remember, the idea is not to check where you went wrong. The idea is also to check where you went right, to see if, like, your answer, which you gave, is actually the same as the answer given by the exam setter. Because sometimes we reach the right conclusion in the wrong way, Right. And you think that, okay, of course, what I'm thinking is right. Well, you are making a logical error. Somehow or the other, by chance, you are reaching the correct answer, but your logic is wrong. So you must always check your right answer just as much as your wrong answer. Okay. And after you do that, take the mock again. And then if you don't score 150, then take the mock one more time. And if you don't score 150, then also then try for NEET or JEE. Right. Because like if you are giving the same mock three times after knowing the answer, you should ideally get full marks. Right. If nothing else, you will remember it from mere memory, right? So that's the thing. Yes, Amrin, tell us.
So for me, I think GK, I prepared GK from by reading newspaper. And for legal, I did only, I told you beforehand that I had read all of R.K. Bhangia, Law of Torts and Law of Contract. And I attempted a lot of mocks. And when I say a lot of mocks, it means at least around 100. So that helped me a lot. And I analyzed every mock at least 4 to 5 times. And when I analyzed it, I read it like a story. So when I was seeing a correct question, like you just said, that, you know, I used to think that how did I reach at the correct answer? Because many a times I noticed that I was reaching the correct answer, but my path was not correct.
Correct.
Yes.
Yeah, it used to happen with me also. It turns out the right answer for the wrong reason, you know, and that is the biggest actually silent killer. Because when you go wrong and you check, then you realize, okay, this is why it was right and I was wrong. But when you go right, you never bother to do that, right? So that's something you must daily do. Okay, great. I think like Rishabh, if you have any more questions, otherwise, like, you know, I would like to leave the floor open to the students to ask their questions. Yes, Aishanya, go ahead.
Could you specifically list books for like each subject, each section? Any books that are, you know, better for the preparation?
Right. Go ahead, guys. What books did you study for each section? Of course, CLAT 2.0. But apart from that.
May I go?
Yeah.
So like... GK has already been very elaborated already, very elaborated. Like once again, if they want, I can repeat the...
Sure, why not?
Repeat my sources. Like Drishti IS is very important for the new pattern. For in the old pattern, I didn't read anything from that site. But when the pattern changed, some of my friends told me about Drishti IS. So that website has covered everything. Like daily, they give around 5 to 6 updates. And that updates are like from the static point of view, and every single thing is covered. Like what are the opinions? Like this in the this CLAT, the paper was very much opinionated. Why did Trump interfere in between? And what were Trump's motives? Like everything is covered there. And moreover, YouTube channel like Study IQ, there we have a GK teacher Prashant Dhawan. He covers international affairs. So mostly these kind of affairs are covered by him. And like he tells about all of the intentions for why they want to do, what is the role of India. The most important thing is how is India affected in that. So these things always, you need to know them always.
Some sort of maths based.
Yeah, for maths, I would suggest R.S. Agarwal for clearing of concepts, and rest the mocks would suffice. And for other subjects like English, if you want to improve your vocabulary, newspapers and novels, they would suffice. But if you want to add on, there is a book called World Power Made Easy, which I completed. And the previous year questions, the pattern has changed, but still the previous year, the legal questions from 2008 to 2019 are still very helpful. Like the reasoning is same, just they have combined five questions to one paragraph. And you have to identify the principles which are mentioned straight away in the last year's paper. So that helps a lot. Like this year's paper also, there were questions around Article 22 and very similar questions which were asked in previous years, but only single question was asked.
Correct.
So that would help.
Okay. Anything else? Any other source that helped you out a lot?
This is all.
Yeah, I think the key is mocks. Yeah, one, even I remember for my preparation, after a certain point of time, every subject was covered, okay, either from some material or another material, right? Word power made easy was something I used to use, back in the day. You know, after a certain point, it's just practice. It's just mocks. Okay. So try and do as many mocks as you can. That itself will give you concept of theory also. And the past year's papers of CLAT will help you a lot now also, because like the concepts which are there in legal, logical, etc., they will help you a lot even now. Even in the CLAT consortium, if you go and see in the study guidelines and the, you know, a syllabus, it has been mentioned over there that study the past year's papers, especially for legal. That will help you a lot. Okay. And you, Amrendra, what about you? Can you tell us section-wise what materials would be helpful for the students?
So I think for GK, Study IQ will do. Prashant Dhawan is a really good teacher on YouTube. And for English, I would say mocks only. And obviously, one can complete Word Power Made Easy by Norman Lewis. And for CR, mocks, for AR2, mocks would do. And for legal, obviously, now it is, you guys cannot do RK Bangia, so I would not recommend it. I would say give mocks, read the articles on bar and bench and live law. And for maths, I'm sorry, I don't have any authority to say anything about maths.
I think R.S. Garawal would do the trick for maths and logical reasoning to certain extent. And then, you know, for English, Word Power Made Easy, right word at right time, you know, Renan Martin, things like this. For GK, like they said, Law Seekho and what was there? Drishti IAS. Okay, books like these. Okay, even we have started one daily GK with Manav, who is sending us on the group. You know, GK, enough sources are there. Okay, primarily editorials from newspapers. That is something called self-study. Okay, that is very, very important. And after that, what's left is legal. Past year's papers, along with, you know, mocks, along with like, you know, some study guides and everything which you can find here and there. That should be more than enough. Okay. First of all, finish off with whatever kind of materials that you can get and try to start with your mocks as soon as possible. Okay, that is the thing. Even if not mocks, at least worksheets, okay, of that particular subject. If you don't have any specific worksheets, take any mock and divide it into the subjects and then use those subjects as worksheets instead of considering it as one mock on its own. Do just the English part. That's your English worksheet, right? Something like this. Okay.
Sir, like, can I add for something for logical reasoning?
Yeah, please.
So, like, I started when the pattern was changed, I was very confused, like, how to progress in this critical reasoning section. Like, in previous years and A-lit also, these questions were asked, but in very less amount. Now, the whole paper was around this only. So, I just surfed and got some GMAT questions. Like, there is a 1000 question PDF. Like, that will completely clear all the doubts in logical reasoning. Like some of the questions in the CLAT paper this year also, they straight away took from that PDF and gave here. Like they didn't also vary the names. Like they don't give paragraphs, like one paragraph and five questions, but they have normal logical reasoning, critical reasoning, like one question and only one questions from one paragraph.
Sorry, could you repeat the source which you said where they give directly into the paper?
So GMAT 1000 PDF, like I'll share right. with you, I have that.
Right. Please share it with me, I'll put it on the group. Okay, and that's true. Many of the logical reasoning questions are from GMAT nowadays. Okay, so that is something we have to remember. All right. Try and do GMAT, and people say that, sir, but GMAT is so much tougher than CLAT, or, you know, even LSAT papers, the US LSAT I'm talking, you know, from there they give. So why, sir? That's too much. That's way tougher than CLAT. So is it going to harm you to do something which is tougher? I always give the example of when you play basketball in practice, the ring is smaller than the ring is actually in the real match. So that you get practice of playing in a smaller ring or a tougher situation. So when you get the larger ring, it's like child's play for you. Similarly, if you're going to practice GMAT level, IAS level, LSAT level, then CLAT will be a joke for you. Look at Amrendra. He's studying Bangia. After studying Bangia, taught and contract in CLAT is a joke for him. That doesn't mean you will go and study Bangia, because Bangia is something you study in college. Okay, but LSAT, GMAT, some of the sample papers you can easily do right now. It's not a lot to ask, right? And then your life will become much easier. Trust me. Okay. So that's the thing. Okay. Anyone else? Any more questions? If you have any question, you can raise your hand. Feel free to take this opportunity to ask your doubts from the toppers of NALSAR. Right? Okay. Seems that, we have had a very extensive and thorough session, basis which, like, you know, many of the doubts, or I would say most of the doubts of the students has been cleared, because we have pretty much spoken about, like, all the things that can arrive in a student's mind while preparing. Certainly all the questions that would have arisen in my mind while preparing have pretty much been answered by all of you. Okay. So finally, then I would like to leave the floor open to both of you to kind of share any thoughts that you have. It could be any random thing that you would like to tell the students about your preparation, any advice that you would like to give them, so that they will have a better time in preparing for their exam. Okay. So Amrendra, why don't you go ahead first?
So I would like to clarify one thing. When I said that I played 4 hours of PUBG, I did not mean that I only played it. 4 hours is just 1/6 of the day. And from 9 to 11 a.m. in the morning, 9 to 11 in the morning, I used to study. Then 3 to 5, I used to give a mock. And then in the evening, in the night, from 9 to 1, I used to study again. So I had ample amount of time in between, in which I used to play PUBG, do college assignments and all. So don't take it like I used to play only PUBG, and you can also crack it by playing PUBG or something like that.
Certainly, certainly. No, I think like this is just a way of saying, if out of everything that Amrendra has told you today, if you took away the thing that he played 4 hours PUBG, then I think you have missed the point of this entire session. Okay. He's not telling you to play PUBG. He's telling you that if you study if you use the remaining 20 hours properly, then the 4 hours you can play PUBG. Think of it. You have got 24 hours in a day, right? 8 hours you sleep, then you have 16 hours. In 16 hours, 2 hours, if you take for your meals and stuff, that's still going to be enough time for you. You take another 2 hours away for recreation and this, that, everything. Still, you will be left with at least 10, 12 hours of solid time to study. Okay. Which is what Vinesh did. If you are attending college, then you reduce that by half. You still have 6 hours time of solid time to study, which is what Amrendra did. Right. So just to clarify, if you're in a college, you should study for 6 hours, even with your college and even with your PUBG and even with your sleeping and your eating and you're having fun, everything combined. Okay. The other thing is, it doesn't matter what your routine is. Okay. As long as you're studying for that certain amount of time, seriously, you are only fooling yourself. Okay, if you are sitting with your door open with a pen and paper just so that your mom is passing here and there and she's seeing that acha beta pad raha hai, that's the wrong attitude. While actually you are making cartoons or you are, playing something, and your mom is thinking he's watching online class. Actually, he or she, they are playing PUBG or watching some YouTube video. You're fooling yourself, aren't you? For me, for example, I used to study at night. So I would have a so-called dinner with my parents. For me, it would be kind of breakfast. Okay. They would go to sleep and I would start studying. Whole night I would study. In the morning, when they would wake up, I would have so-called breakfast with them, which was my dinner. And then I would go to sleep, because that was just my style of studying. But that doesn't mean that if in the middle of night, my parents woke up and suddenly entered my room, they would find me studying only. Okay, because I would actually study. I just like studying because it was like quiet at that point of time. And in the morning, I had those lists prepared of like GK and this and that, whatever it was. And I would give it to my mom or dad and I would say, ask me any question. Okay, and then they would ask me and I would be able to answer it. So they also got the confidence, okay, this guy is not fooling around, he's actually studying. So they were also lenient with me, okay, fine. Otherwise, parents also know, they think like, what is he doing whole night? He's staying awake, whole day he's sleeping, what nonsense. But they saw that I was able to concentrate better at night when there was no disturbance of traffic and this and that. So they allowed me to study like that. Okay. I was fortunate like that to have some liberal parents. Okay. But I'm sure no matter whatever you do, if you show your sincerity, your family will also give you that much leeway. Okay. To study however you like. Even if you're playing PUBG for 4 hours, they'll not mind because they have seen you studying for the remaining time also. Isn't it? So as long as you maintain that discipline and sincerity, people around you will also understand and reciprocate accordingly, right? So that's the thing. And Vinesh, what about you?
From the perspective of my family, in the whole 1.5 years, they never even asked me how is my preparation going. They were just like, "Ho hi jayega," jaise bhi. They were always like chill, and they didn't ever ask me also that how, what is your mock score, what is your rank. They didn't even take anything in that. They just, my father just motivated me that you can do it. It's not that hard. I cracked NEET last year, so this can also be done. So yeah, the family was quite motivated me. And like one of my mentors, he's passed out from NLS. So yeah, he gave me some tips. And like one of his, once he told me that for the top tier colleges, like I can speak in Hindi, na?
Haan, no problem. It's okay.
So he said that Mercedes ke showroom se hamesha Mercedes hi banti hai. Aur kabhi bhi Nano ke showroom se kabhi Mercedes nahi banegi. So top tier colleges ke saath yehi scene hai.
Bilkul.
Yeah. Bilkul. Aur matlab hamesha, when he used to like wear NLS jerseys and jackets, so I can get jealous of him so that I can focus more. And like he used to advise me to sleep at least 7 to 8 hours a day, which I applied also. Like it's necessary if you're studying 10 to 12 hours a day. So you need to have a proper sleep so that you can again wake up on time and give and start your preparation with the whole of your energy.
Absolutely, absolutely. The correct mental state, the correct state of mind is very important for preparation. If you don't sleep, if you all remember the day before the exam, what I advised you all was sleep. The one thing I can advise you to do tonight is sleep. Tonight is not the night to study. The time to study was 1.5 years. Okay, don't think that tonight you will study and you will learn everything. Tonight, go to sleep. Because if you don't sleep, you waste your time, you stay awake out of anxiety, you are going to mess up your exam tomorrow. Isn't it? So, that's the thing. Great. So, Vinesh, any final words from you before we wrap up this session? Would you have any words to say to the students?
So like it's doable. Like CLAT is not a very tough paper which you can't crack. No paper is that tough that which you can't crack. If you are preparing very hard and sincerely and being honest to yourself, like being honest to yourself is the most required thing in your preparation. Like you can't fool yourself. You can fool others, but you know yourself where you stand. Like you attempt mocks, you know what your score is, where you stand, what your rank is. So just give all of your effort which you can for the next 6 months. This is only 6 months from May. Then you will have 2 or 2.5 months vacation, and then colleges will start. Life will change entirely. The college life is completely different from what you are doing now, and you will have to study that time also. CLAT is nothing in front of what you study in law schools, and I realized that in the last 10 days only. So like.
So in 10 days, you have realized that your entire life has changed, right? Even before you have stepped foot inside the college, you just from the online class, you have realized.
Yes.
Okay, great. And what about you, Amrinder? Any final words for us today before we wrap up?
So in the end, I would suggest 5 things. The first one is that give mocks and analyze them really well and try giving 180 days are left. So try giving at least 70 to 80 mocks. And second is that read the Indian Express daily. Reading newspaper, analyzing it, analyzing the news, analyzing the editorial is the key. And, third thing is that do not panic. Try meditation. And it is something that is going to help you throughout your prep in the main exam hall and even further in life. So do not panic. Don't take too much stress. Fourth is develop habits, because motivation is something that is temporary. So try developing habits. Fifth is that have a plan B. CLAT is an unpredictable exam. So fill other forms like PHU, Jamia, Punjab University and all that, or SIMBI or ALIT. Leave ALIT because ALIT is a tough one. So have a plan B. And because that, that you have something to rely on. you are not that much insecure. And because I have seen many people who dropped the whole year, this year, and when the exam was getting postponed again and again, they were starting to panic. They started to panic, and they panicked a lot even in the main CLAT exam. And they did not perform well as much as they should have done. So having a plan B works. For me, it worked.
Okay. Thanks a lot, Amrinder. I think that was really good advice. Read newspapers, have a plan B. Okay. Do a lot of mocks. All of these things, they will really hold you in good stead. That's very, very good advice. I would stand by each one of those things. And before we conclude, Rishabh, I would like your inputs as well. Any final words from you, before we wrap up for today?
Like the only thing that I have to add to this is that I hope to see you guys on Monday and that we, do this together for the next 6 months, and then you all achieve whatever you set to achieve.
Right. Our aim is to make you all juniors of Amrendra and Vinesh, or to make you juniors of Rishabh. So it just depends on who will be the one ragging you, right? Or it could be somebody from law school as well. That's it. All right. Great. I think like whatever has to be said has already been said. I think like we have extracted as much knowledge as we could out of Vinesh and Amrendra. I really hope that you all will apply these, tips and tricks to your daily life and your preparation. Don't just treat it like you have watched a movie where, some people have given some kind of advice and some kind of, motivation. Because like even Amrendra said, motivation isn't forever. Motivation is daily, right? Every day you have to stay motivated. Rather than that, if you believe in value building, you building character, then that you don't need to refresh every day, okay? Your character is your character. That stays with you, all right? So, very, very concrete advice you all have received today. I really hope that you all will apply it in your life. Thanks, Rishabh, for joining us today. And really, my sincere and utmost thanks to both Vinesh and Amrendra. And of course, Ashik, who had to drop off due to some reasons. He messaged me separately. But all three of them have really given some, valuable inputs to us and have shared their time and their expertise with us. So I really want to thank Vinesh and Amrendra once again for joining us, for sharing their wisdom, and for being a support for all the students here today, so that they also may replicate your success. Okay, it's a new pattern, it's a new paper, you all are the pioneers, and hopefully the students of CLAT Sure will follow in your footsteps. Okay,
thank you, sir. Thank you for having me here.
Absolutely. Thank you for having me here. Thank you all so much. Thank you both. Very glad that, CLAT Sure could be of some use to your preparation. And we really hope that some more students also benefit. And, just a word for all of you. Vinesh and Amrendra have very kindly agreed to be at hand in case any of you all need any kind of advice. So if you all want to get in touch with them, just you all can DM me and I will put you in touch with them. Okay. So that, they will share.
Yeah, sir, I'm in the group. They can, if they want, they can directly message.
Perfect. That's even better. So if you have anything you would like to ask Vinesh or Amrendra, you all can just message it on the group. Okay. And then they would get back to you on that point. Okay. So once again, thank you all so much for being part of today's session. I think it was very, very successful and enlightening session for all of us. And like Rishabh said, see you all on Monday. Okay. Thank you all so much. Thank you. Take care.
Thank you, sir.
Bye.
Thank you, sir. Bye.